Wi-Fi, very cool, they're really cheap, and there's like, you know, five of them, they're very cool. We had a dojo on getting some ideas, and one of the things that came up was the idea of running ASCII Star Wars on this. We didn't have time in the dojo, but then I ordered a display from China, and it came a month later. And then I hacked on it, and I've got it working.
What do you need?
So I won't actually show it, it's pretty much pointless for you guys to see this. So the display came, and I hacked it together, so it was running. And basically, these are really cool boards because you can connect. So this thing on boot up connects to my phone when it's on hotspot mode, and connect to a channel service on the internet, and stream it into memory, and then render that very trivially onto this tiny display, and will run. So one thing I want to point out was actually really, really interesting. So this display arrived like I came home from work and it was there on my doorstep. I go upstairs, turn my computer on, check out the latest MicroPython, and literally 2 hours earlier, Damien had finished committing the drivers that allowed me to display this. So it was kind of interesting that this happened. The actual code for it is here on GitHub, and this is the other thing about this that's really amazing is it's 118 bytes. So that's the thing about Python, right? It's
you basically took out a comment.
Without a comment. You can do so much with so little code. And I really want to.
Use the. Is there a webcam built into the laptop?
Probably, but I'm not sure.
Because then you could just hold it up in front of the webcam and display it onto the screen and you'd see it. No, he just holds the chip. Oh, he's got it all set up.
So actually this is an image of it running on a breadboard.
Wow.
There is a video. And there's a write-up of it if anyone's interested in more details on Medium. So that was actually from the dojo. This is the board, and this is...
Ah, oh, cool.
But I want to...
Go full screen.
Yeah.
I'll have to actually flip through to Vimeo first.
Yeah, it's embedded, so there's one.
Yeah. So one other thing I want to mention is this is obviously very much a DIY job. I've got some batteries and cellophane, which actually worked really well. This thing was £11.
In the bottom right.
This thing was £2.70. And the batteries are probably more expensive than somebody can buy. So you can do this sort of thing. It's really, really cheap these days to do this sort of thing. So I'd recommend everyone to try and.
You realize you've probably got the cheapest way to watch Star Wars ever.
Oh, yeah, the licensing costs.
So the stand shoot first? Which
version? So if we.
Supply your own sound effects, I guess.
Pew, spoilers. Pew, pew.
And just for the.
It's been 38 years. You've had enough time.
We have, C3PO and RTD2. So, yeah, there you go. That's
right. Woo! That's it. Awesome.